Why can't we just be friends?
What's your name then?
Nazareth.
Nazareth, I'm Charles.
Hi, Charles.
We're friends.
Okay.
So where are you from,
Nazareth? I'm from the Holy Land. I was born in the Holy Land. I live in Southern California, near Los Angeles.
So they're both Holy Lands?
Yes.
In one way or another?
Yes, from Hollywood, the yes. Holy Land.
Holy Land, Hollywood. Holy. Where, what's...
Oh, thank you.
Oh my goodness, you're...
Is he gay or what? No, I'm sorry. Okay, go ahead.
I'm not afraid of my manhood.
Yeah. I'm afraid of your manhood. Sorry. Is this on tape?
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
Oh, my Lord.
Yes,
Lord, forgive them, for they don't know what they're doing. Okay.
What's your main ministry?
Comedy. I like, you know, in 1992, I came to know Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. So I was doing comedy in the clubs and wanted to quit, but God said, I want you to do it for me. So I use comedy as a tool to reach, to get the message across.
So what kind of response have you had so far?
Wonderful. I mean, it's becoming the last 10 years, no, 12 years, it's been full time. Wow. So I make my living, I feed my family, I can afford to have my wife sit home. So praise the Lord. It's a great way when you're minister, you get paid for doing ministry.
Yes.
So
it is a good thing.
Yeah, it's a wonderful thing.
Now you're from the Holy Land. Have you ever gone back?
You guys have the Blue Jays here, right?
Unfortunately we do, yes.
Oh, you
no offense to our partners in Toronto. I'm just a Montreal fan. So.
You know, Canadians, you are so kind. You have the soft names for teams,
and we
like
say
the
sorry
Blue
too.
Jays and the Oilers and stuff. You need harsh names that scares people,
the
like
killers.
The black ice or the minus 50 degree. What was it? What is outside? Minus 20?
We've been indoor all day, probably minus 20. Yeah.
I'm from California. We evacuate in this kind of weather.
That's minus 2 Fahrenheit.
That's cold.
No, minus 4 Fahrenheit, sorry.
Yeah, I left 69 degrees in L.A. today.
Celsius?
No, Fahrenheit. Who's that's, Celsius? That's
Celsius, there's some
I don't
guy
know her.
Back there. No, him.
Oh, him, Italian guy.
No.
Hi, I'm Celsius.
Celsius.
Sounds like a disease.
what kind of crowd do you hit with your ministry?
You know, this is interesting because I try, and a lot of people say it's hard, but I try from age 12 to age 90. So I do the Life Fest and I do the Spirit West Coast and the festivals, mm-hmm. which is for the younger crowd. I also do sometimes, I'm doing a big retirement home, a huge,
really?
I mean, no, they're paying $5,000-$6,000. It's not. I mean, I'm not doing it because I'm a nice guy.
Yes.
No, I would do them for free. I've done them so many years for free. I've done prisons for free. It's not the money.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But I'm saying it's the whole gamut.
Mm-hmm.
Is it gamut or gamut?
Gamut.
Gamut.
Yes, you got it.
Which
right.
is an instrument?
That's a gam.
What's a gamut?
I don't know. Some old English guy must have.
Oh, okay. Gamut, which is an. You can buy it at the mall, whatever.
When it comes to churches,
yes.
Do you think Christians are too stuffy?
We don't
laugh at ourselves too enough?
You know, we do. I think if you take each Christian person and put them in one room by himself and put comedy, mm-hmm. they're not as stuffy as they are around other Christians. We're more
That's
stuffy
true.
Around other Christians.
Yeah.
I mean, we do stuff when we're comedians, when we're together, and we just laugh and joke, and we know Christ will be in the midst and laughing with us, but we can't go on stage and do that stuff. Because somebody's going to go, ooh, that's offensive.
Too much religion.
Too much religion.
The religious side of them
right.
comes out and it catches their funny bone and gone.
That's right.
Now, you head up a Christian comedian organization. What is it?
It's called the Christian Comedy Assoc, which is, we have 300 Christian comics.
Now, that's in North America.
In North America, okay. And, you know, Leland Clausen. Last year, we had about 5 Canadian comedians show up for it. And we have people like Sherry Shepherd from The View. Mm-hmm. We have Shonda Pierce, Ken Davis, Brad Stein.
Yep.
You know, we were just in Nashville having one of our conferences. And it's great because it keeps Christian comedians together, mm-hmm. fellowship time, accountability, which is a wonderful thing.
Oh, wow.
I want to encourage everybody, be in accountability, even if you're 15. Have someone to be accountable to,
mm-hmm.
a boy, boys with boys, girls with girls, yes. and it's a great thing.
Who, now if we kind of get into the accountability thing, who are you accountable to?
Nobody.
Oh.
I killed them all. They knew too much. You know, actually, I'm an accountable to a pastor that we just met by chance, and he...
He's still alive, though.
For now, until I tell him what happened in Canada this week.
What happens in Canada stays in Canada.
Yes.
Actually, freezes in Canada. And then.
Yeah.
So, what's his name?
Oh, his name, Pastor Randy Christian. He's a great, he was a head of psychology department in Oregon, in Portland, Oregon. So he's a great guy to just go and sit and open up and you know, encourage me about spending time with my wife, with my kids, with my family. That's wonderful.
So when it comes to ministry, how do you see comedy in ministry? Like, what is it? It's obviously not just how to make people laugh and go home. What is it? Is it more than that?
Of course, you know what, right now we are saying that as comedians, but it is the truth. Right now, comedy is the best tool in our time to reach people. It's past music, it's past everything. And you know, for example, in my show, and that doesn't mean every other comic, every comedian does that, is I like to put truth in there. And at the end of the show, if I'm given the opportunity, I like to give people an opportunity to receive Christ. That doesn't happen every night.
True.
Some churches want to do a bridging event.
Yeah.
So we share a little bit of truth. And when people like you, because comedy is a great way to get people to accept you. Homosexuals use it all the time. Hollywood use it all the time to push their messages.
Yeah.
You know what? Humor was created by God. Satan doesn't create anything. He just perverts it.
That's right.
You know, God created sex for the marriage. Satan perverts it into pornography. God created food. Satan perverts it into gluttony. And God created humor. And Satan perverts it into the dirt you hear in comedy clubs and on Comedy Central sometimes.
Yeah.
So, yes, comedy is a great tool. You want to talk to, you want someone to accept you? Be funny with them. Talk to them. They like you, and then you get to talk.
Now, here's one question about your sketches and what you do in your sets. Do you have, do people that know you say, hey, can you do this one? Do you have, like, a favorite that people tend to say, Nazareth, can you do this one?
Yes. I think it's my day at the Pentagon with you. See, you're already laughing. Now that you're laughing, would you like to know about Jesus?
Yes.
See, that's what we do. We make you laugh, then we give you the message. Jesus beat the devil. That's awesome. I like this.
With two sticks.
With two sticks?
Yes.
Wonderful.
Not just
was
three.
Was it a Chinese restaurant? Were they at the Chinese restaurant? Oh, that's, oh, two sticks, the cross.
The cross,
oh,
right.
Yeah, okay.
Before we go, do you want to tell our viewers what makes your heart beat when it comes to ministry? Is it more than just comedy?
Of course, it's always more than just comedy. And you know, for me, just to go up and do comedy and leave, there's a sense of that, you know, it makes people laugh, and it's a great medicine. We need to laugh. Laugh every day. You know, the older you get, the less you're going to laugh. So start laugh. Just laugh. Laugh. Find clean humor. You don't need... I know lot of teenagers listen to Comedy Central. You know, you're putting dirt in your head. You don't need that. There's enough clean comedy that you can watch on different shows, Bananas and other shows, and you can watch it. But at the same time, you know what? I want to tell people, you know what? Jesus Christ is the only way, and that's the truth that God gives you in the Bible. That's not for up to you to say, well, that's good for you or me. It's fixed truth. It's a point of reference for us, the Word of God, the truth of Jesus Christ. And I want to encourage everyone, you know what? You can be a strong believer and be as cool as you can be. There's the devil wants you to believe that if you're a Christian, you're not cool, you're stuffy, you're that. No, it's not the... It's not. The funniest people I've ever, the coolest people I've been around, they're Christians. Why? We know where our boundaries are, and we can just swim freely within them.
That's right. Do you have a website? You tell everybody?
Yes. Yes. What's your name?
Charles.
My website is charles.com. No,
I'm sure there's one out there, but
actually,
I don't
it's NazarethUSA.com. It's Nazareth.
Nazareth.
If you don't know how to spell Nazareth, get in the Bible. It's NazarethUSA.com is my website, and you with us.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Charles. I appreciate it. God bless you for what you guys do. It's awesome. We need more Christian networks to reach people.
That's right.
Because there's a lot of garbage out there.
That's right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
God bless.
Thank you.